Overview of cover image block. In this video we will walk through to another block in Gutenberg editor, which is the cover image block. This block allows you to basically add a hero header like section where you can have a background image and a title or a large text on top of the image. So let's have a look at this block, what this block does and how to use this block. So how to add the cover image block. As similar to any other block, you can add a cover image block by clicking on this plus icon, or the plus icon appears on every block on top of or bottom, or you can click on this add block button and select search for cover image and click it to add this. And you can also add this block by typing a slash and to open this little menu and start typing cover image, and you'll see this, you can click it. So this way you can add the cover image block. Once the block has been added, you'll see this placeholder for this block. It says you can drag image here or add from library. So you can add, you need to first add an image to this block. You can add from the media library, you can choose any image you have already uploaded, or you can upload an image directly from your computer. So, and another way to add an image is, obviously you can drag an image from anywhere on the web and just click drop it on this VIM, and you see this blue placeholder which says drop file. So this way you can add an image, and once the image has been added, you'll see this another option here to write your text. So you can write your text to your Gutenberg, and you can also make use of the enter key to line break the words block USB. And so now let's see what toolbar we have on the Gutenberg cover image block. So this toolbar on the top is for this block, and this toolbar here is for to make some formatting to this text. Like we can make this one bold or italic basically, and we can also mark through, use this one, or we can link a word here. And the toolbar here is the block toolbar, which is divided into four sections. The first one is the transform option. These are the block alignment options which align this whole block, and these three options here are the text align option, which will align the text you see here, and this one here is to edit the image. You can click on this and edit the background image like this simply, right? So the another toolbar is obviously on the right side bar panel. There is also some controls here for this specific cover image block. The first one is to make the background image fix. What this does is, basically this is a really neat option. It makes your block a parallax section. Let's have a look, save this and have a look on the front end. And you'll notice when we scroll the page, this image is a fixed background image and this text scrolls with the page. So this is a nice parallax effect. You can achieve this by simply enable this option. Just turn this option on and you will have a parallax section with the nice content on top of it. The second option or control here is to adjust this dimness, which is the overlay on the background image. You can adjust its opacity from 0 to 100. 100 means the image will be hidden completely sorry, and 0 means there is no opacity, almost no opacity. So by default it is set to 50. You can adjust this means this dimness based on the image you have to make the content readable. Next control we have is the text align option. Basically this syncs with the text align option here. If I click here, you will see this syncs here. So this also does the same job as this one do. So we can align the text within this div or section or block like this to left, center and right. And this is additional CSS class option. As similar to all Gutenberg block, you can assign a class to this block to achieve some specific stylings. So these are the options for the Gutenberg cover image block, and I hope I have covered everything. The image to the block, let me just review it quickly. One thing I did not show you is the transform option. So this block transform into one one block, one other block, which is headline. If I click on this transform into headline option, this block will be converted to the headline block and the image will be lost. Let's see how this works. If I click on this headline, you see this, the headline, this block is converted into headline. The formatting is retained, however there is no image now. I can also convert it, transform it back to the cover image block, but you see it like this. The image will not be restored when you transform it again from headline block to cover image block. You need to add the image again by clicking on this or this, or you can upload a new image also like the previously. So I'll select an image again, and there you go, we have this cover image block back. So hope you like this video. Thank you.